Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today, we are going to make a PDF form accessible. But before we get to that, please take a moment to hit that like and subscribe button. Now back to the video. This document is a continuation from a previous video where I designed a form in Microsoft Word. Now that I have this document over in Adobe Acrobat, the first thing I want to do is make it accessible, and then we're going to add all of our form content. So let's begin by opening up the tags panel. And the first thing I'm going to do is change this section tag to a document tag. Then we're going to delete out some of the blank tags. Let's ensure our image has some alternate text. I'm going to right-click the figure tag, select properties, and add alternate text. And this will be the Accessibility Guide logo. Then we have our H1, and then we have some of our content ready to go. I want to clean this up a little bit, so I'm going to launch the reading order tool, and I'm going to select first name and select text paragraph, and do the same on these other areas where we're going to add our form field. There was some extra information in there because I used a certain technique to add the underlines in Microsoft Word. So what we can do now is actually artifact these blank spaces. I'm simply going to hold the control key from within the tags panel, select all of those blank spaces, right click, and select change tag to artifact, and then select OK. Now, just for fun, let's go ahead and run the accessibility checker to determine where we're at. And the document looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and fix the title right now. I'm simply going to add form sample and select OK. All right, let's begin adding our form accessibility. There's a couple of different methods we can use to add form fields to this document. Let's go ahead and first go to our tools menu and ensure that we have prepare form added to our quick tools menu. And under forms and signatures, we simply will select add if it's not already there, and we can select open. And this is where Adobe Acrobat can actually apply these form fields automatically for us. Let's go ahead and do this for this particular step. I'm going to select start, and we get a pop-up window saying the document needs to be saved. So let's go ahead and save this document. And it automatically placed these form fields because of that work that I did in Microsoft Word. By adding the underlines and the checkbox areas, it was able to accurately apply these form fields to my document. So that's really just the first step of adding form fields. Now, if there are sections that were not added properly, like let's just pretend we had a section over here that did not have a form field, in the prepare form window, we have the ability to add a text field, checkbox, radio button, submit button, date button, and signature field. And you would simply select one of those items and add it to your page. You can add as many as you want, and there's also some advanced features you can do for alignment. For example, if we wanted all of these checkboxes aligned, we could select all of them, right click, and under the align, distribute, or center section, we could align them to the left, to the right, to the top, or the bottom. And that will make them a little easier to see. Now there's another method for aligning form fields. For example, if these form fields were all out of whack, we can go to view, show hide, rulers and grids, and add grid. And this will help you align your content when designing a form. All right, let's keep going with the accessibility here. I'm going to close the prepare form option, and then let's run the accessibility checker just to get a snapshot to where we are. Now there's a few areas that are missing. For example, we have tagged annotation failed on this signature field, and then we have tagged form fields failed, and field descriptions are missing from these checkboxes we have. So the first thing I'm going to do is come in and actually delete those extra checkboxes I added. And then let's take a brief look at the tags panel once again. And right now, I want to tag these form fields. Now there's a few different ways we can do this. We can use the reading order tool to simply drag a box around our form field. And it can be a little touchy in that you only want to select the form field itself. Now, I don't love this method because it's really hard to grab just the form field. So another thing that we can do is I'm going to create a new blank tag, a P tag in the tags panel. I'm going to select the options button and then select the find button. From here, I'm going to change the drop-down menu to unmarked annotations. And then I'm going to select search document and select find. This will begin to find all of the form fields that aren't currently tagged in the document. So once I find the first one, I'm going to select tag element, and then it automatically takes you to the next one, and I'm going to select tag element again and keep going through all of the form fields in this document, and then select okay. Now, the benefit of creating that blank P tag is I now have all of these form fields in one spot, and now I can begin to place them into the correct location. So the first thing I want to do is I'm just going to start Control X and Control V-ing these things into the right location. So let's take first name first. I'm going to Control X the object out, and let's move it into our first name field. I'm then going to create a new tag called form and drag first name into it. And then we're just going to rinse and repeat. Let's take email address, move it to the right location, create a new tag called form, and move the content into it. This can become a little tedious, but it is a very important step. And I'm simply placing all of these into the right location. Got one more phone number. All right, now let's go ahead and run the accessibility checker once more. We now have all of our form fields in the right location. So I'm going to select the accessibility button and then select accessibility check and then start checking. Now from here, it looks like everything has been applied, but I want to validate my form descriptions. So if I select prepare form and I right click one of the field names and select properties, this is where I want to adjust my tooltip. Now, depending on how you adjust and create your form, sometimes the tooltips are not accurate or sometimes they're missing completely. It all depends on how the form fields are entered into the document. But I like to adjust my tooltips to be more accurate anyways. So I'm going to say enter your first name and select close. Let's go ahead and open up the properties for last name. And I'm going to say enter your last name and let's select phone number. And then let's say enter your email address. What's nice about the checkboxes is that they already are set up. Are you new to accessibility? We could add a question mark if we wanted to, just to add a little bit better experience here. We can say, please sign this document. Actually, I'm gonna delete these and just say, sign your name and select. All right, now let's save this file and let's turn off our grid lines by view, show hide, rulers and grids. All right, a really quick test we can do to ensure our reading order is proper is by clicking in the first area. I'm going to say my first name is Sean, and then I'm going to hit the tab key on my keyboard. And I just want to make sure that all of our fields are set up properly and that they go in the right order. So far, everything looks great. Now, if we wanted to, we could add some conditional formatting to our fields. I'm gonna delete out the entries I made first. And then let's open up prepare form and let's open up phone number and select properties. So if I go to the format tab and change the format category to special, I have the ability to select phone number and then select close. And then when we test the phone number, if I try to enter any letters, it doesn't work. But it does work if I add in our digits for the phone number and then it formats it properly. All right, let's take this into a couple more steps. I'm going to launch the PDF accessibility checker and we're going to test this file for PDF UA. And there's a couple of elements we need to address. First, there's a content failed. Let's open up the results in detail and I'm going to expand this menu. Okay, earlier when I had deleted those P tags, it's now telling me the text object is not tagged. So this is an interesting thing to fix. what we can do is in the tags panel, I'm going to create a new tag to just house some of my content. And I'm going to select the options button, select find, and let's see if we can do unmarked content, search document, and let's start with find. And I'm going to start tagging all of this content. All right, that didn't seem to find the right spacing. So another thing we can do is go to the content panel and find these blank spaces in the container tags. Now this can be a little advanced sometimes, but I'm just going to walk through the tags panel and expand all of these areas that has the blank text. I'm then going to select the text containers in the content panel and right click and say create artifact. And then I'll just leave it as part of the page and select okay. Let's go ahead and go back to our tags panel. And earlier we had selected these other lines and content. I'm going to select all of them from this one P tag, right click and change tag to artifact, and then delete that P tag out. Now let's save our file and launch the PDF accessibility checker once again to test. All right, that did get rid of the content issues, so that's great. So that was two methods to get rid of some of the artifacts on the file. And then last but not least, we need to add our PDF UA identifier. That's what's missing. Now to do that, we need to open up our preflight menu. So to do that, I'm going to select the optimize PDF button in my tools panel. If you don't have it here, you would select tools and then optimize PDF. And then I'm going to select preflight. This brings up a very special window. Now there's tons of options in here, so just bear with me. The first thing I'm going to do is select this little wrench icon, and this looks for individual fixes. And then I'm going to do a search for UA, and under the document info and metadata area, there is an option called set PDF UA one entry. When I select that, I then have this option on the bottom right corner of the window to select fix. It's going to prompt me to save my file again, and then we can launch the PDF accessibility checker or the pack tool once again. And let's drag our file into the tester. And we now have a fully compliant PDF UA and WCAG accessible form. Thank you for watching this video on how to create accessible forms. Something that you should note is that I'm working in a somewhat controlled environment. I had the ability to add the form fields in Microsoft Word, and it was easy to sort of adjust those form fields in Adobe Acrobat. Occasionally, when you're creating forms from scratch or adding form fields in Adobe Acrobat, it can be a little more challenging than what this video covered. The plan is to release additional videos in the future to create more complex, accessible forms, but I hope you enjoyed today's video. And if you haven't done so already, please take a moment to hit that subscribe button, and I will see you next time.